Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you how to control your Mac with your keyboard. So I see many Mac users use their mouse or trackpad for just about everything. They select every menu item, for instance, instead of using a keyboard shortcut. You can certainly speed up your computer use if you learn some of the keyboard shortcuts. And there are other ways that you could also use the keyboard to speed things up. For instance, in the Finder, you can use the mouse and the cursor to go into different folders and find things. But you could also jump directly to a folder without ever touching the mouse or trackpad by using the command under Go to go to a folder. And you can see it's Shift Command G. So here, without ever touching the trackpad, I'm going to do Shift Command G, and it's going to open up this Go to the Folder window here. And I can quickly type something. I full path somewhere. Now, for some who are slow at typing, this might seem like it takes longer. But if you're quick at typing, this is definitely faster. Use the tilde to show that you want to go to something in your user folder. And most of the time you do. So tilde slash, and then type something like, say, if you want to go into your pictures folder, like that. And you don't even have to use the correct case there. I could have a lowercase p there as well. And the tilde character on most keyboards, the US keyboards, is the key to the left of the 1, just above the tab and below the escape. You need to use shift to get the tilde there. So I hit go, and you can see it changes that Finder window to my pictures folder. And this could be something several levels down. So you can see I've got, say, under documents. I'm going to use the arrow keys here, another good shortcut to go up to the documents folder. And I could see I've got under documents, I have lots of folders here. And under my project, I have media. I could have then done Shift Command G and then tilde slash documents and then my project and media. And it takes me right in there. Now, for launching apps, you can use the Spotlight menu to quickly launch an app without your fingers ever leaving the keyboard. Do Command Space and do a Spotlight search for the app, like TextEdit, and then simply hit Return. And there it brings to the front TextEdit or launches it if it's not already there. I can hide TextEdit with Command H very quick and easily. And I can use Command Tab to go between the apps I have open. So I can go back to TextEdit like that. Now, if you want to access a menu item with the keyboard but you can't remember the keyboard shortcut, or perhaps it doesn't have a keyboard shortcut, you can do that using Control and F2. And that, you can see there, the Apple menu at the upper left corner of my screen became highlighted there. And now I can use the arrow keys to move between menus and select one using the space bar. Now, you can also access the dock this way using Control and F3, and you can see it brings up the dock, and I can use the arrow keys to move between items there to launch something if I want. Now, remember, whenever using the F keys, everything depends upon your setting under System Preferences, Keyboard, and how you have this set. If you have this set turned off, then you need to use the FN key in addition to the F key to get there. So check this setting if it's not working for you, or just hold down the FN key on your keyboard. Now let's switch over to TextEdit here using Command and Tab. And I have a document I haven't saved here yet. I am going to do Command S to save it for the first time. And I have this dialog box here now. I can move around in this dialog box very easily using the Tab key. So I can go to the different fields in it, and you can see that it just goes between all of these. In addition, I've got the Save button. It is highlighted there in blue. If I hit Return, it will instantly select Save because that's the default button. There's a Cancel button, and there's a shortcut for every Cancel button you ever find, and that's Command Period. If you hit Command Period, it's like pressing Cancel. Now, say I want to access more things than just these few that the tab is going between. Like, I want to access that New Folder button at the bottom left. If I go to System Preferences under Keyboard and under Shortcuts, there's a setting for that that allows me to tab between all the controls. I can turn that on or use Control F7 to toggle between these two settings here. So now when I am in this dialog box and I use the Tab key, you can see I can highlight that New Folder button there, and I can use the space bar to select it. Matter of fact, right now with New Folder selected, I can use a space bar to select New Folder. Command Period will do Cancel, and Return will do the default button, which is the Save button. So there are some of the basics, and you can go even further in System Preferences, Keyboard Shortcuts by looking at some of the other special shortcuts that are here and adding your own. So for instance, if you want to access Notification Center with a keyboard shortcut, you can do that by going to Mission Control, turning on a shortcut for a Notification Center, and then assigning some keys to it. And that will bring it up. Otherwise, the only way to do it is using the cursor to click over here. And there are lots of other types of commands that you can add, the built-in ones, but you can also create app shortcuts, create your own by using any menu bar items. So anything in here that doesn't have something like, you know, if you look under Window Keyboard and System Preferences, for instance, there's nothing there. If you look under Edit Clear, there's nothing there. Anything you find that doesn't have a keyboard shortcut, you can reassign by typing in the name of the menu item and assigning it to the specific application or all applications and assigning a keyboard shortcut to it. So really the sky's the limit on how you can control your Mac using the keyboard. You can actually get to the point where you don't even have to use the mouse or trackpad at all unless you're doing something very graphical like editing images or something like that where you need to select something specific.